Alright guys, going to do a video on a do-it-yourself, a quick how-to. Going to show you how to make a bivy out of Tyvek. First want to discuss what is a bivy and benefits, pros, cons, things like that. First off, bivy is pretty much a waterproof bag that you can put your, say you can sleep inside of. You can put your sleeping bag inside of it. Say you're in a wool blanket, a sleeping pad, whatever. You can get all that inside of there, sleep inside of it, and it's a waterproof bag and a protectant to your actual sleep system. So say the military sleep system comes with a Gore-Tex bivy. And Gore-Tex is pretty much the product that came out after Tyvek. Tyvek is a waterproof moisture barrier used on homes. It's put on after the plywood, particle board, whatever the sheathing is on. They wrap the house in Tyvek and then they put on whatever for type of siding. So I'm going to use the same product and make a bivy. Because these bivvies are expensive. You can get anywhere from, you know, the military sleep system that comes with the bivy is a, you know, you can find one used for about $100. But then there's also aftermarket one bivvies that you can buy, and you're talking a couple hundred dollars. So it's something I can make off of scrap. And a lot of times, guys, you go to a new construction house, and they had just finished wrapping it in the Tyvek, the waterproof barrier. They got rolls of this stuff, scrap, that they just throw into dumpster. So don't be afraid to hit up and take advantage of these resources. One man's trash is another man's treasure. So I'm going to readjust the camera and show you materials and get back with you in just a second. All right, guys, going to go over the materials I'm going to use. Need a good straight edge for some measuring. Need this is double-sided carpet tape. And as you can see, I put it in my vise, cut down the middle. I think this is 1.5 inches, something like that, and cut down the middle. That way it just uses less material. You can use it more often. Also, need a good marker. Doesn't matter what kind of marker it is, just something to make marks with. Here is my roll of Tyvek, and this is the, I believe it's a 3-foot roll, and you can just see basically it's made out of materials woven together. It's like a plastic type material. So and then you'll need whatever it is that you're going to measure to make your bivy. This is my Thermarest sleep pad. That last trip we went on, I took the young boys on, hit that storm, and some of my blankets got wet on the bottom. I did not have a bivy. I just slept right on this pad, right on the ground. And so that's why I've decided to make a waterproof bivy. So I'm gonna get this out here, lay it out, and use this as my measuring device for my cuts to make on the bivy for the outline. All right, so I'm going to roll out my Tyvek. And put my sleeping pad right on top of it. I guess I could go ahead and blow it up. It just gives it a little more rigidness, a little stiffer to make a better measurement. So, let me see what I'm going to use to cut with. I believe I'm going to use my Mora. All right. Then you take your Tyvek and wrap it over the end of whatever it is you're sleeping with. Roll this thing out. Figure out roughly where you want it to be. Put your straight edge on it. make you a good straight mark. That's for nothing other than a line to cut on. So I'm going to pull it up, cut this line. Two-sided tape comes in. We'll take one side of the carpet tape here and see where I've cut it. Comes undone nicely. Go down to where I made that mark and just line this up to where it's fairly close to that edge. Roll that edge down all the way to the top. Another thing, a bivy helps. It helps you combat conduction. Helps you combat that the ground sucking out your body heat. And so you have a ground cloth of sorts under you to protect you from that element. Benefit of doing the bivy this way, or using the Tyvek, is that the bottom piece where you're gonna put your feet is one solid piece. All right, so make a cut when I've got to the top. Make sure that's all pushed down nicely. And come over to the other side and do the exact same thing. Find my line over here. Put this on my line. And giving credit where credit is due, got this idea from another fellow on YouTube, Yankee Prepper. Some of you guys are familiar with him. He sells his own coffee and does that sort of stuff. He has different vehicles he makes and different ideas on there. Seen a cool igloo he made. So just a quick shout out for him. Want to check out his YouTube channel, Yankee Prepper is his name. He's got a lot of do-it-yourself stuff on there. And I believe he's out of Montana. So, let me get this tape around up here. All the way to the top. And cut it just like I did the other one. Push it down and make sure we got a nice seam. Alright, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a seam across the top. Reason for that, we're going to make it somewhat like a mummy. I don't currently use anything that's got a mummy type system, but this is a more layer of protection you can give yourself, covering up around your head, around your face, things like that. So I'm just going to run a seam. Looks like you need to cut that a little bit more. All the way across the top here. Safe knife practices. Forgive me on that one. Alright. top, doing the exact same thing. And you can cut it to where it meets up with your other piece of two-sided tape. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is go down to the bottom, undo this this little piece that protects the second side of the tape. See if I can get it off here. Alright, so be careful once you do this, because now that's the sticky side that's going to create the bond between the two pieces of tape. So I'm going to set that off to the side, come do the other one. And the benefit with this Tyvek is that you can paint it. So if you don't like this one says Lowe's Home Improvement and all that business on there, you don't want all that on there for your camping gear, I can understand that. You can hit this thing with some spray paint and camouflage it. I'll probably end up painting this one brown, to be honest with you. I'll get this all off here. Alright, so now what you can do, you get that all off, is you want to fold your bivy back over. I think I'm probably going to put my sleep pad back in the middle, give me something again to make it a little more rigid. Get it back to that bend that I initially made. Try to line up the edges. And smash that down. And do the same thing. Right. You gotta be careful with that. Once that tape bonds together on this Tyvek, it's pretty tough to get it undone. Alright, now what I'm going to do is, you can see that my sleeping pad is right here, and then it ends up giving me plenty of room. So when I'm stuffed in here, say with a couple wool blankets or something like that, I've got plenty of room to move around. I'm just going to make a bit of a line right here, give me an entrance point, that way something still stays under my head. And keep it seamed real well. And then end up cutting that out. Again, just gonna use one more. All
and still get a good quality brush. And you get to go ahead and make it. Here, I have across the top, remove that little protective piece of paper. Two-sided carpet tape, I bought it a while back, is I want to say about $3 for the roll, so it's not too bad on price. Here. I'm going to pull my sleeping pad out. Flip it over, trim up the excess, try to make it nice and neat. No purpose other than cosmetics. get that take shape. Now, obviously, that thing was noisy. So what you can do is that if by wadding it up like that takes out some of the noise, you can actually even wash this thing. I have some spray paint up here.
Change up the look a little bit on it.
But, you know, it's definitely not necessary at all. Point is that it does what it's supposed to do, and that is protect your gear and to keep it waterproof. So, I just wanted you guys to see this quick do-it-yourself. You can save yourself some money by doing things yourself, and this is a piece of Tyvek that somebody else could throw away, but we can recycle, get use out of it, and it's going to make us for a more comfortable stay in the woods. So, thanks for watching. Hopefully this helps. God bless.